wanted to talk about, this topic was suggested to me by Mike or somebody, but I wanted to talk about it. It's something I've thought a lot about. So let me try and set the stage, and I'll try to talk for no more than about 30 minutes and leave the balance of the time for questions. If you think about it, the development of space and spaceflight generally in all of its various forms, to include military, intelligence community, civil space, science, human spaceflight, has had a common characteristic very unusual with regard to other activities of a societal nature, and that is our space development so far has been all government all the time. Very few exceptions. Certainly CompSats, more recently and with far less certainty on the outcome, commercial imaging, most recently cargo resupply to the ISS. I think the contract that we closed when I was at NASA, I believe in 08, but if not exactly in 08, pretty close, doesn't matter. So these are the kinds of things that so far have even had a sniff of commercial behavior, and they're not many. And of them, communication satellites are by far and away the preponderant thing. And yet we've done a lot of other things in space over the last 60 years, starting with ICBMs and going on to putting people on the moon, one of them an Ohio resident, and building a space station and many other things. So it's I think, historically unusual to see so much of an enterprise be purely governmental in nature. Now, that reflects, and is reflective of, the fact that space exploration and development are primarily, at least in these first few decades of what will be a millennial enterprise, but in these first few decades, they've been primarily an element of and an expression of national strategy in terms of both hard and soft power, and including both the scientific advances and the economic influence that